Once upon a time, there was a woodpecker, a big, beautiful one, that lived in the woods in the American South. But as people crowded in and the forests got smaller, this ivory-billed woodpecker began to disappear. The last firm sighting was in 1944, and after that, it became a kind of ghost. People who love birds and love watching birds insisted it's still out there, it's alive, it's wild, it's surviving, but when they looked, and a lot of them looked, there was no proof. And then recently, as you may have heard, something happened, maybe. Reporter Carla Wohl picks up the story.
It happened here in Arkansas's Big Woods, a swamp that's been described as America's Amazon.
It suddenly burst out in front of us and flew across the bayou and into the light, and then we both yelled, Ivory-Billed.
And when I first saw the bird, even though it was at a distance and it was naked eye, I thought, oh my God, that's it.
Eyewitness sightings of the ivory-billed woodpecker, the Lord God bird, as people used to call it. Old black and white footage doesn't do it justice. It was spectacular, with a call no serious bird watcher could resist. When University of Arkansas at Little Rock professor David Luneau heard that the woodpecker had been spotted in the swamp, he grabbed his video camera.
I keep mine running the whole time.
And joined the search party.
All aboard.
All aboard.
It's probably closing in on 1,000 hours.
1,000 hours looking and listening for the ivory bill.
I heard a woodpecker tapping over there, but he stopped.
He searches from dawn to dusk.
Woodcock, yep. Oh, cool.
80% of bird watching, he will tell you, is listening.
Pileated woodpecker. And we've heard, that's our third one we've heard today, and we haven't seen one yet.
One day in April of 2004, Leno was puttering along, his video camera propped up in the canoe.
And just left it running, had it recording like I always do when I come out.
And this is what the camera saw, a good shot of his brother-in-law in the front of the boat, and there, just above the paddle handle, some movement. Even when you zoom in, it's fuzzy, a flash of white. The amount of white you see there is going to be very important.
Did you see that? Did you see the white on that bird?
When he got home, he downloaded the video to a computer and examined it frame by frame.
And you see a flash of white.
Right.
That's the back of the bird as the wing is starting to unfold.
He came to believe the bird was the ivory-billed woodpecker, though at first he wasn't sure.
Kind of blurry.
Yeah, not kind of blurry. Go ahead.
It's blurry.
It's blurry.
Blurry or not, this scrap of video is the only hard visual evidence in a controversy over whether or not the ivory bill has come back from the dead.
It's a woodpecker with exactly the color pattern of an ivory-billed woodpecker.
John Fitzpatrick, the head of Cornell's respected lab of ornithology, is unequivocal.
Absolutely. The ivory bill has broadly white throughout. So here's a bird with white in its back and broad white along the back end of the wings. It can only be an ivory bill.
The video is clearly not an ivory bill.
Jerome Jackson, an ornithologist at Florida Gulf Coast University, is not convinced.
Found, Cornell Lab of Ornithology, ivory-billed woodpecker. I think there should be a question mark there instead of an exclamation point. Right over there.
Jackson has studied woodpeckers for 40 years. He says the bird on the video is the pileated woodpecker, the ivory-billed's smaller cousin, still abundant in the Arkansas woods.
I think I'm looking at pileated woodpecker in flight and looking at the backside of the bird's wings.
As a pileated is flying, its wings are held back like this. And so the white is in a different position than you would normally see on a pileated woodpecker. It's holding its wings as if it were paddles, paddling through the air.
We're not looking at the underside of a wing here, we're looking at the upper side of a wing. From above, we see this huge white patch along the back end of the wing of an ivory bill, and we see just a little bit of white of a pileated with a jet black back.
Fitzpatrick backs up his argument with audio evidence. They have set up microphones in the woods and in 17,000 hours of recordings have something that sounds like the ivory bill's call.
Sort of a
Russ Sheriff is one of Cornell's audio experts. He plays the only known recording of the bird made in 1935.
Eek, eek, eek.
And now a portion of a recording that we made on January 29th, 2005.
Jackson still is not convinced.
Those recordings are not definitive of Ivory Bill. They possibly could be a blue jay.
Possibly, says Sheriff, but the last note of their calls is different. Again, here's the one Sheriff says may be the Ivory Bill.
So you can see there's one, two, three, and then this fourth one is a little bit lower.
And now a blue jay.
All at the same frequency.
Still, Sheriff admits the audio is not conclusive. What they really need to prove the Ivory Bill is alive is a good, clear picture.
Well, this looks like as good a spot as any, I guess.
And so Luneau is placing motion-detecting cameras in promising places.
A total now of 10 cameras.
Hoping to capture a snapshot of the Ivory Bill. In the 623 photos taken so far, there are some pretty good pictures of the pileated woodpecker.
But not the elusive ivory bill.
Not the elusive ivory bill.
What we have is a good hypothesis that ivory-billed woodpeckers might be out there. They've given us hope. And I like that hope. I would like to think that they have survived.
Yeah, I mean, it's got woodpecker chisel marks.
And that we might have a chance to bring them back.
We share some sort of collective guilt about having destroyed the habitat that took this bird out and a lot of other creatures to the brink of extinction. And we've got a chance to keep the species going. We've got another chance here.